Okay, so this bears going over a second time just because it was a lot of information. My generous videographer wasn't really filming that up close either, but it's all good. Got to see how messy my office is. Like, you didn't already have an idea, by which I mean the one person watching. That isn't me. Anyway, we've got sales equal to fixed cost plus capital divided by the contribution margin ratio, price minus the variable cost divided by P, and we can multiply both sides by the denominator and get rid of it. And then at that point, we can also divide it, get rid of the P2, so that we have PS times P minus variable cost equal to P times capital plus F. You could have it in either direction. So you have that. And then what do? We've got two P's. Ah, that's crazy. I don't know what to do. But then we just distribute it out. So again, that'd be S, P, or again, like I said before, let's make this more intuitive. So it's price times S, sales minus sales V equal to PK plus PF. And then the secret here is getting rid of that, so that's now a negative PS, negative price times sales, right? And then just imagine distributing that out. Okay. So really what we have is P times K plus F minus S, minus sales, capital, fixed cost, sales, and that was equal to negative sales times variable cost. And then all we do, once again, is divide that, this over here, we just divide that underneath here. So then we'd have K capital plus fixed cost minus sales equal to P.